Hello everybody and welcome to today's Sunday sermon, which is the 24th Sunday in ordinary time. And today we are being challenged again by the Lord to forgive one another. Otherwise, if we don't forgive one another, we can't expect to be forgiven. Today we have a fascinating little incident with Peter. Saint Peter decides to be a great fellow, and he wants to ask Jesus a question about forgiving, to forgive people who hurt us, our enemies. And in the rabbinic law, which he grew up in the Jewish tradition, they said you can forgive three times. So Peter decided to be extra generous, and he said to Jesus, how often should I forgive my enemies? Seven times? And he gets very surprised with Jesus' answer. He says, not seven times, but 70 times seven. In other words, always forgive. Seven is a word that signifies perfection in the Bible. And when you say the word seven, it means the complete number. So he means you should always forgive. There is never any occasion when you're allowed not to forgive your brother or your sister or anyone who hurts you as you consider them your enemy. So then he gives him a great story about the unjust Stewart. The Stewart who came to his master with a huge debt. The debt was enormous, so much so that the man had no hope. And to fix that debt, the only answer to it was to sell this man into slavery with his wife and children. So the man begged on his knees. He went down on his knees and begged the master. And the master said, his heart melted. He says, okay, I'll write it off. You're free to go. Now, this is a story by Jesus, of course, a parable. This man goes out and he finds somebody who owes him a little small bit of money. And he wants to choke him. He says, give me my money, you owe me money. And it's only a little fraction of the amount that he owed to his master. People saw it and they got annoyed and they took him back before the master. And then the master dished out what he intended to do in the first place. So the message there for us is there are three messages, really. We will not be shown mercy unless we give mercy to others. The judgment day will have no mercy given us when we have been proved not to have been merciful to the others. Number three point. Yes, we are more like the man who had the huge debt, because all of us, and I mean every one of us, are sinners. This sounds very morbid, and some people might say, oh my God, he's really making us feel bad. Please don't feel bad. Why shouldn't we feel bad? Because we know we are forgiven. From the Pope down, all of us are sinners. All the saints came to realize that they had sin in their hearts. And the reason why they were happy was because they knew they were forgiven. We know we are forgiven because of Jesus' death on the cross. We may consider ourselves the nicest, the kindest, the most spiritual, and the most virtuous of people. Yet we are sinners. The vilest, the crookedest, the most evil of people are sinners. Everyone in between, and including all, are sinners. On top of that, all of us are loved by God. We know that when we think that we have no sin, that we are on a slippery slope to self-destruction. And actually, it's from 1 John chapter 1 verse 8, in this epistle, John says, if we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not with us. So, okay, we are sinners. Does that mean we must go around banging our chests, looking for mercy? In a sense, yes. But we are redeemed. And that's what makes us happy only, is that we are forgiven and we are loved by God. That's what Jesus' death proved on the cross for us all. All we have to do is to accept that, to welcome that mercy into our lives and know that we are sinners. At the same time, we are of great value because we are loved and given mercy by God. That's what makes us happy and should make us happy. So, but in the meantime, we have no right to condemn anybody. No right whatsoever. Even those who offend us and upset us and have stolen from us, and those who say bad things about us, and we found out all this, we have no right to say that they are sinners. We have no right not to forgive them. We must forgive them. We must have mercy on them. Otherwise, we won't be shown mercy. I quote now Pope Francis, who readily admits that he's a sinner and in constant need of God's mercy. And he said, "This is me, a sinner, on whom the Lord has turned his grace." And he said, "This is what I said on the night I was elected pontiff. I am a sinner, but I trust in the infinite mercy and patience of God. And I accept in a spirit of penance this role to be your Pope." Father Jean Vianney of Ars, otherwise known as the Curé of Ars, in France, back in the 1800s, became a great and famous man. Even then, people were coming from all over the world to go to confession to Jean Vianney. But of course, as the devil hates when some good is happening, some people in that parish began to want him out of there, remove him. So they set up a campaign whereby you would sign a form, a petition to the bishop to get rid of Jean Vianney from the parish. So one morning at breakfast, the curate said to Jean Vianney, "There's a petition going around for to be signed by the people, a letter to the bishop to remove you." And Jean Vianney said, "Bring me that letter. Bring it to me. I want to sign it." So this was Jean Vianney's humorous way of forgiving those who hated him. So, my friends, when I speak to you, I speak to myself. We must forgive one another. We must nurture that part of our Christianity more than anything. So today we can begin to understand the truth about ourselves, that we are on the way to holiness when we learn to ask for forgiveness and see that we are sinners. And then knowing that we are forgiven, we are spurred on to do the great thing, the impossible thing, to forgive those who for some reason are very mean to us, are spiteful, are hateful to us. In a way, that's not our concern. May God bless you and have a lovely week ahead.